Hi everyone, my name is Mykel Dwaileebe. I am a color specialist and stylist at Hairthrone Salon here in New York City. I am going to show you guys all today my most requested look from my clients, which is a effortless tousled beach wave. So what I'm going to be using today is a 1 1/4 inch curling iron. It has a clamp. This is what I typically use on my hair to get this style. Some people like a flat iron, but this is usually what I like to use. Okay, so my hair is finer in texture. So what I did to prep my hair is yesterday I washed and blew it out straight so that I had a nice, smooth, even canvas to work off of. So what I'm going to use today just to style it out, just to begin, is only a thermal protectant. I don't like to use a ton of product in my hair before I'm styling. The reason being is I like to have my styles and blow dries last me as long as possible. So what I'm going to do is first just take a typical paddle brush and comb through, make sure that there's no knots, no tangles, anything like that. And then this thermal protectant specifically is from Alpha Park. It's one of the color lines and product lines that we use at Hairthrone. And it's just a really light aerosol. So I'm able to just go through, kind of mist it all over. I don't really pre-section it in order to use this product specifically because it's light enough where it'll kind of just mist throughout. And then I again go back through with my brush and just make sure that it's like basically evenly dispersed. You don't want to have any areas that it feels heavier or weighted down from using one product. So my biggest thing for me when I'm styling my hair, I have extensions in my hair, so I actually have quite a bit of hair on my head. So my main priority is always making sure that I have nice even sections so that I can stay organized through the whole style and make sure that I don't miss any spots. Moving forward, it makes things much, much easier. So I'm just using, I have a few different kind of clips, but these are alligator clips. And I just go through. Doesn't have to be anything perfect, but I'll do one section clipped up on top. And I always start on the bottom up. For me, it's just easier to work through. And again, not make sure I'm not missing any areas, any sections. And I'll kind of show you guys the sections once I'm done putting these up. So depending on the amount of hair you have and your texture, you don't have to do the exact same amount of sections that I'm doing. This usually just works for me, again, going back to the amount of hair that I have on my head because of my extension. This just kind of breaks it up a little bit. If you have more hair, you're gonna have probably more sections. If you have less hair, you can usually break it down into like maybe 2 or 3. So right now I have 4 sections, including the hair that I left out. So you can kind of see top section, 2 middle sections, and then some hair that's left out. And you'll be able to see some of my extensions with that. Okay, so the first section that I left out is pretty fine. So I'm just going to basically, I kind of eyeball it, and I'll split it into 2 and kind of pull them forward to make sure that they're even. One of the main tips that I like to tell my clients is the section of hair that you're going to curl, you don't really want it to be thicker in diameter to the barrel of the iron that you're using. If you take a section and it's too much hair, it's too thick, it's not going to evenly heat up, and then you're gonna have a hard time getting that curl to stay because only part of the section heated up and the other part isn't quite as warm. Also another tip that I love to tell my clients is you don't have to have your irons on the highest heat setting. I like to do like a medium setting. This one has a dial for the different heat settings, and I don't have it up all the way, but almost all the way. So now going into actually taking the section. So this section, I'm going to start in the middle of the section and curl my way down. And then once I clamp the iron and I turn it, when it's gonna overlap, I'll open the clamp, kind of pull it down a little bit, and then re-turn it up. So I like to go through, heat it up a little bit. This is right in the middle of the section, and I'm going to wind it up. And then when it's about to overlap, I'll open the clamp, kind of drag it down, and then re-close it. And I'll kind of do the same thing over and over again. I like to leave a little bit of a tail out. This is gonna give it more of that effortless look. So you can see, it's not like a typical glamorous full spiral curl. you want to have a little bit of a straightness at the end. That's going to give it more of a lived-in look, something that is going to kind of fade out nicely over the duration of the day or the next day. If it starts to fall a little bit, it'll just fall to a looser version of this and just look even more effortless, which is the current trend. So same thing on this side. I'm going to go through middle way of the section up. I like to kind of heat it up a little bit before. Mm-hmm. So you can turn it over. Once it starts to overlap, that's when you'll open the clamp, kind of drag it down, and then pull back up. The amount that you leave out on the ends doesn't have to be the exact same each time, so I wouldn't get too stressed over the importance of that. As long as there's something left out, it'll be fine. And if there's ever a section that you see that you're not sure about, if you left too much, you can always go back through and fix that. So now I am taking down my next section. I'm doing the same thing. I like to, when I'm styling my own hair to stay organized, I basically will just eyeball it, but I will kind of slip my hair down the middle and pull those sections forward. That way I don't have any other hair that's left out in the back that I'm going to at the end look back and then have, you know, some straight hairs. So this just helps me personally stay organized. And then I like to work my way from the middle of the back of my head forward. Again, for the same reason being that I'm not missing hair back there. So same thing. The sections, like I said, they should be no thicker than the diameter of your curling iron. So you're gonna go through, kind of heat up the section, midway through, turn it, and then once it's gonna overlap, you open the clam, kind of drag it down a bit, and then do the same thing. It's easy when your hair is prepped smoothly, like when I began with my hair pretty straight. This was just blow dried straight. This wasn't straightened with an iron, but that way when it's smooth and straight, when you leave the tail or a little bit out at the end, it's not going to look mismatched from the smoothness of the curl. If you have textured hair and you're not smoothing it out and you leave out a little bit of the end, you're still gonna have whatever texture you began with. So you wanna make sure that you're gonna have your hair pretty smooth to start. If you do need to actually straighten your hair before you start a style like this because of your texture, make sure that your hair is completely cooled down before you begin with this curl, or else the curl won't hold. It'll fall out pretty immediately. So same things, going through. And then I might like to make sure that I'm not pulling apart any of the sections of curl until the complete end. I wanna make sure that everything has completely cooled before I'm touching it, or else the shape of the curl or the wave will just completely fall out right away. As far as the direction that I'm curling, I like everything to go away from my face. So it's also helpful that I have began with splitting the hair in the back and pulling the two sections on either side forward. That way I know that everything on this side, I'm going to wave this way. Everything on this side, I'm going to wave this way. And you also don't have to have anything perfect. This is supposed to be effortless. This is supposed to be lived in. It's polished, but it shouldn't be too polished. So if something looks a little bit out of place, feel free to just leave it as is. And at the end, if you still have something that's bothering you, you can always go back and alter any of it. So I'm just gonna leave this. I'm gonna go through and brush this section just to make sure. So again, I'm gonna start in the back. You don't have to start in the back. This is just something that I personally like to do. It helps me make sure that I get every hair. If you are experienced in styling like this, something that you can do to smooth the ends out a little bit. Not everyone likes to do this, or not everyone is able to. When I get down to leaving that little bit out on the ends or the tail, sometimes I'll pull through with some of the tension of the curling iron and the clamp, just to kind of smooth it over a little bit so it's not pin straight. Just like this. You just kind of pull it through. You're not completely opening the clam, but it's still not completely shut either. You leave a little bit enough room so that way you're not pulling the hair with it, but it still has enough tension where it's gonna grab onto the hair and kind of smooth it over. Yeah. Once we get to the end, you'll also see that I have a little bit of a curtain bang. A lot of people like to style those out first to make sure that they're styled properly. I like to style them and then clip them to kind of set them. So I usually wait all the way till the end to do those, just so that way they're not gonna be in the way of the other hair I'm curling because they're clipped back. Mm-hmm. Yeah, see this tail I left out a little bit longer, which is fine because you want it to be a little bit mismatched to look a little bit more of that natural tousled look. Still, like I said, a little bit smooth over, and you know, you want it to look uniform to an extent, but you also don't want it to look perfect. So now because I have all of my hair split down the middle in the back and pulled forward, I know that I haven't left any hair out in the back and that I'm not missing any stragglers. So I'm gonna take down my next section. Same thing, I just, with my fingers, eyeball, it doesn't have to be perfect. Pull it through, and then I have nothing left in the back. I always like to go through and smooth it a little bit so that it doesn't catch on to anything. Another little tip that I tell my clients, depending on the shape of the curl that you're looking for, I usually say the less hair in your section, a little bit tighter the curl will end up. The bigger the section, it'll be a little bit looser, but still keep in mind that you don't want it to be too thick because then it won't heat up evenly. Also, with the direction of the curl, I was saying earlier that I like to have everything on this side going away from my face, everything on this side going away from my face in the other direction. I also like to tell my clients that it's not extremely important to make sure everything is going those exact directions. Usually, I'll say in the back, if you mismatch the directions that the curls are going, it can end up looking kind of textured and cool, and then just making sure that everything around your face is going away. You don't want the curls for this style in particular curling towards your face because it's you basically want to open up your face, especially if you have any of those like face framing layers, any curtain bang, anything like that. That kind of cut and look is made to style out away from your face and just kind of open it up. As far as how long I keep the section of hair in the curling iron, I just kind of tap it. You'll notice me doing that throughout. I just tap it, and once it feels warmed up, but not too hot to the touch, is when I know that I can either travel down in that section with the curling iron, or I can just completely release it, depending on where I am with that curl. You don't want your hair to be extremely hot to the touch, but you also need to make sure that it's warmed up, that so it'll actually grab a hold to that shape of the curling iron. For me in the salon, I would say that this is currently, like I said, the most requested look. This is the look that I most often will do with my clients when I'm finishing up with either a haircut or if I've done their color that day, or even if they're just coming in for a blowout. This is, I think, probably more requested because most people can usually mimic something similar at home. So it's something that the day following them being in the salon that they usually can, you know, sleep on it and either wake up and still have the same look, or it's something that they can wake up and just kind of touch up a few pieces around their face and it'll either be a little bit more lived in because it's looser, or it's held the style pretty well. we're just working our way up, almost to the last section. Each section really has its own importance, but I would say, in my opinion, the last section on the top of the hair, or excuse me, on the top of the head is the most important because it lays over top of everything else. So if everything underneath is perfect and you don't really get the top right, it doesn't really matter. No pressure. You kind of have a little bit more room for error with the sections underneath, again, because everything on top lays over it. As long as there's a very similar shape throughout, that's probably the most important. And then perfecting the top section that's gonna cover everything else is gonna be kind of your key. Again, this barrel for this curling iron is 1¼ inches. This exact curling iron is from Babyliss. It's the same iron, same brand iron that I've used basically since I started doing hair. This one is titanium, which I find to hold the best over a longer period of time. Everyone has their preferences and, you know, their favorites for different tools and stuff. Like I said, I've used this brand and this model curling iron since I started doing hair, and it's been a while, so I really like it. Last one in this section. Okay, so now I have everything from each section except for my last pulled down. And then if you look in the back, you can see I haven't left any hairs out because I split everything right down the middle, pulled it forward. And that's just allowed me, again, to stay very organized, making sure that no stray hair is left behind. So my last section, same thing, just kind of pulling it forward. Brushing through everything to make sure it's nice and smooth. Sometimes I like to clip one side out. I find that with this last section, sometimes I'll end up, because I have more layers in this section than the rest of my hair, sometimes some little stragglers will get left behind, so I like to just split it and hold it there so that way I'm not missing anything. Same thing, I always start in the back. It's just personal preference. I think most people usually start towards their face and work their way back. I kind of work opposite. And you wanna make sure that you're always you wanna make sure that you're always holding the curling iron vertically or diagonally. You don't wanna end up holding it horizontally. That is a method of curling, but it's just gonna give you a completely different look. So for this style, you wanna make sure that the iron is either completely vertical or on a slight angle, depending on which side of your head that you're on. Wait, can you move the mirror for a sec?
Yes, I wish.
No, that's okay. This way a little bit. Wait, this way a little bit.
Down?
No, that's good.
That's good?
Yeah. So keeping your iron upright, once the hair is gonna start to overlap, that's when I open the clamp slightly, pull it down, and then turn it again. You only wanna open the clamp enough where you have enough room to move it down. You don't wanna completely open it. If you open it too wide, you're gonna lose that section of hair. It's just gonna fall right out. And then you kinda just leave it. I also like to leave, if you have a lot of layering around your face or curtain bangs, a lot of people now have curtain bangs, it's so popular. I like to leave those out for the end, like I was saying earlier, because I like to clip them to set them in style, but I also myself will have a hard time styling them from time to time. So I like to leave them at the end so I can see how everything else is styled and I can go back and kind of tweak them here and there. So they're not completely set in style from the beginning. So it kind of works in my favor in that way as well. So I'll get like close enough to them, but completely leave them out for the very last section. I personally do bring my iron up a little bit high because I know that my hair will fall a little bit. So it gives me a little bit of room for my hair to fall. If your hair holds the style really, really well, you might want to only style it like midway up in the section. So like here, instead of all the way up here. If you find that your hair will fall, then kind of pulling it out a little bit, a little bit higher. Last one before where my curtain bangs begin, and I'll kind of leave those out until the other side is styled. Okay, and I have this side clipped up, so I'm going to take that out, comb through, make sure I'm not grabbing any of the curls, because like I said in the beginning, you want to make sure that everything is left out that has already been touched so that way you're not pulling the curl out until it's completely cooled. Touching it, making sure it's warm, but not too hot. This is a style that I find that I can, on the next day, just kind of rewear it. Sometimes I'll take a large tooth comb and just comb through it to make it a little bit effortless the next day. Some tips on having this last longer. For my hair personally, I sleep on a silk pillowcase at night. I find that that really, really helps with the amount of frizz that I wake up with, but I find that it also really helps hold the style. It's a little bit softer on your hair. And so it has made a big, big difference for me, even with just a blowout, even if I'm not styling my hair. It's worth that. It's worth it. You can get them cheap on Amazon. So you can get them cheap on Amazon.
What do people know?
The plug. So my iron is still upright. It's a little bit angled, but not to the point where it's horizontal. Going back to that thermal protectant spray that I was using in the beginning, I personally like it, not necessarily just the specific brand, I love the brand, but I like the texture of the spray because it's an aerosol. I find that an aerosol is better versus just a spray for my hair specifically because my hair is finer in texture, it's a lighter weight textured hair. It's a product that when I spray it on the hair, it's not going to weigh it down. You don't want to be using a thermal protectant that when you spray it, it dampens the hair, and then you go to use any iron, whether it's a flat iron or a curling iron, and it sizzles. That's what we want to avoid. Okay, so now everything is curled. I can feel it. No stragglers, and I have my face framing left out, my little curtain bangs. These are the most fun to style because you never quite know what they're gonna do. It's not just you, it's me. Can you turn it? This, I really need the, like, yeah, a little bit. This way. A little bit this way, that's good.
Perfect.
Okay. So I'm just gonna be looking in a mirror while I do this because this part specifically can get a little bit tricky. So depending on the length of your curtain bangs, mine fall kind of just below my cheekbone. So it's not enough length where I'm going to be wrapping it around the curling iron because of the size of the curling iron. So I basically just want to get a nice motion in, a nice little, not even a full curl. So I'm going to take my iron, again, still curling both these sides away from my face in either direction. And I'm gonna have my clamp on the barrel facing downwards. And I'm gonna clamp it halfway still, kind of hold it, touch it till it's warm, and then just kind of pull it through. So you're not getting a full curl, but you get enough movement where it's no longer straight. And then at the end, when it's all styled out and everything, if I need to tweak anything, I can. I'm gonna go through and just kind of reinforce it. And then before I move on to my next section, on the other side, I'm gonna take these little clips, and these are nice because they don't crease your hair, and I'll kind of clip it up in the direction that I want to stay. It doesn't need to be perfect because I'm still gonna comb it through at the end, but this is just going to allow this curtain bang to cool down and set in the exact motion that it's in right now. So this section, same kind of thing, the clamp is gonna be facing downwards. And at a full curl, enough to feel that it's warm but not super hot. And then just kind of pull it through. Basically, you're not using the iron to create the exact shape when you're doing your curtain bangs. You're just using the iron as a tool to heat up the section. And then when you're clipping it, as long as you're using a clip, if you're clipping it, that's what's really going to set in the shape. So these I'm going to leave as is right now. And the next step, you can either use your fingers to comb through your hair, or if you have a wide tooth comb, I like to use a wide tooth comb in particular because you're not gonna have any oils, any product residue, anything like that that's gonna pull apart your hair. This is just gonna be a nice clean surface. And I like to start at the ends of my hair and just kind of work my way up. In this section as well. Work my way up, avoiding my front face rain pieces. I still want these to cool a little bit. And then I like to look it over, see if there's anything that I potentially missed. This one's a little bit straighter, so I'm gonna go through, just kind of tweak it. So you don't need to resection your hair if you find one in the bottom. Again, kind of what I was going back to saying a few minutes ago was that the priority of this whole thing is gonna be your top section because that's gonna lay over top of everything. So the underneath, you still wanna put effort into it and make sure that it's gonna match everything else. But as long as you have some sort of curl formation that's similar to the rest, that'll be enough. So because I just did this one, I'm gonna let that sit and cool for a second. And then you can just kind of feel your pieces that you clipped away if you did that, and they're cooled down. So I'm gonna take these out. Just lightly comb through these. I don't want them to completely lose their shape, and they're sometimes a little bit problematic. So I just wanna make sure that I'm doing less. Less is more with any sort of like face framing. You can either leave this style more of a smooth look like this. This is a little bit more like kind of glam. And you can use a traditional hairspray or shine spray to leave it in this kind of texture. I personally don't love it to be super smooth and styled out like this. I like it to be a little bit more textured. So I'm going to use a texture spray. And this is one from Seven that we have this at the salon right now. You can really use pretty much any texture spray. I like to use texture sprays because they're more of a dry spray versus a traditional hairspray. This is going to give you a little bit more volume. I like to start at the bottom. Just kind of fluffs it up. And then you can even use it similar to a dry shampoo. I don't usually spray it directly on my root, but a little bit below. And it just gives it a little bit more bounce. So I'm gonna do this entire side first so you can see it in comparison to the other side. Texture sprays will give you some sort of hold, Again, I like it a little bit more of like a medium hold, not super light, not heavy. But it's not a spray that you'll typically feel residue in your hair after. So you can already see the volume on this side, not quite as smooth. I personally don't feel like you can overuse texture sprays because it's a dry spray. You can always comb through it and it just breaks it up a little bit. Versus this side, if you just left it, it'd be a little bit more of that kind of glam look like I was saying. So kind of taking, doesn't have to be perfect, spraying at the root, spraying throughout the rest of it. Again, like I said, I don't like using a ton of product in my hair to set my hair before I'm styling because I don't like to have a lot of residue, anything weighing down my hair so that I can wear it longer. But I do feel as though a texture spray you can use quite a bit and it's not going to make your hair dirty where you feel like you have to style it out all over again shortly. And then to finish it off, any sort of like hair oil, less is more. Again, with anything smoothing, less is more. I like to really work it into my hands, almost like kind of a lotion, and just on the very ends. This just kind of seals everything. It'll give an element of shine. It smells really good. And it just gives your hair kind of a glow where it'll feel a little bit healthier. And you can kind of mess with it. Go through, make sure everything looks kind of complete, making sure that there's no pieces that are left out. The front pieces, if you ever feel like they're not laying right, you can go back through as many times as you need. This is the final look. Nice, effortless, lived-in look. You want to make sure that it looks polished enough, but not like you spent all day on it.
Beautiful.